deal. First of all, thanks, Drew, for putting this together. I know, you know, there's kind of a lot of crazy stuff going on right now, but hopefully we're trending in the right direction. And when you get behind a chalkboard, you can talk some football. I think that all makes us feel a little bit normal. So definitely appreciate you organizing this, Drew, and putting this on. Like Coach said, I'm Jace Rendell from UW-Whitewater, the defensive coordinator here. Trying to make sure I can click through. There we go. Coach the DBs. I'm from Cambridge, Wisconsin. Grew up in Wisconsin. Played at Whitewater, left for 2 years, and then came back. So got a lot of passion for sports in Wisconsin, high school sports, and the Warhawks as well. So I'm going to get right into it. I go fast. Everybody in this, you can have this. I can share it via Huddle. It's all yours. So everything that I have here, I can send it to you. No questions asked, and it's all yours. So, you know, coaching's teaching. I think we got to always make sure that we understand that what we want to do is we want to influence and educate the kids that we're working with. So be a great teacher. When you watch the film, when you watch your guys play, are they doing what you're asking them to do? Are the drills translating to the game? Are you doing things that actually show up on game day? And, you know, if you're not, well, then there's some barrier there, right? Are we not communicating? Is there some issue between you and the young men? Or maybe you just aren't doing something that's practical. So just always got to look in the mirror and make sure we're doing things that are actually showing up on game day and they're helping the kids. You know, I got a daughter that's 2.5 years old. And she's trying to climb into her younger brother's crib, right? So I'm coaching her to climb into the crib. What am I coaching her? I'm coaching her to grab on top with the hand, take your foot, step up on the mattress, press yourself up. I'm teaching her to use her hands and her feet to climb into a crib. And I say that because that's how our bodies work, guys, for football. Hands, hips, and feet, right? That's what we should be coaching on every snap. Right? Are you looking at the feet? Are you looking at the hands? The hips connect the lower body and the upper body. But we always want to be coaching something every snap. Look at one of those three things. Give the guy a correction, guy or girl correction, ASAP. My objective, I think all of our objective is to get our kids to play fast and confident. And if we can do that, we're doing our job. Okay, the drills that I'm going to fire through here. Drew, I got to be done about 8 o'clock. Is that about right?
Yes.
Okay, so block protection, ball drills, leverage drills. Probably won't get into 4 or 5, but we're going to go pretty quick here. So Bill Belichick, you know, I try to take stuff from everybody and anybody. And, you know, this is a quote from him, defeating blocks and tackling. Those are the two most critical fundamentals that any defensive player needs. The New England Patriots work on tackling and getting off of blocks every day. Okay, I can't say we do that right now. But we probably should, because if they're doing it, why the heck wouldn't we be doing it here at Whitewater? So, but those are the two things we're going to emphasize for these first two parts of this talk. Hey, Dave Aranda, he's the defensive coordinator for Wisconsin, then LSU. Now he's the head coach at Baylor. Used to coach D3 football back in California in the early 2000s. This is him as a high school coach, near foot, near shoulder. In 1995, he's teaching at a clinic, a little different setup, but near foot, near shoulder. And that's the first thing I want to emphasize as we look at drills and we take on a block or we tackle, get the near foot in the ground on the near shoulder. And that's where you're going to get a little bit more power. Okay. So this is actually, as I say that, as you look at the setup, we should either take a step with this foot and put it right there, or the right foot should be forward. Okay. If I'm hitting with my right shoulder, my right foot should be close to him. So all we're working here is hips, low to high, clubbing up, simple. We worked on it today at practice. Don't want a bear hug. I want to go from low to high. I think I need to do this here. Sorry. Optimize video. All right. Low to high, low to high. All right. Too much bear hug there. Club up, club up, club up. Let's see the next one here. There we go. That's not bad. Right. Again, we should, the feet are wrong here. The other foot should be forward, but all we're working on is that club up part. All right, low to high, low to high. Okay, a lot of guys, you know, that's a pretty good rep right there. Again, you can see the hips getting engaged. You can see the hips snapping. Bang, you want to get those hands up close to your eye level. but we want to be lifting.
Even tackling.
Load of high. Drew. Okay, here's another clip here of an next drill. I actually stole it from somebody else, but I love it. Okay, you're just close quarters, 2 yards apart, putting that piece together, right? I'm goal line tackle. That's what I call this. Nice and close quarters. Again, trying to club up, trying to connect the feet through the hips and the hands. All right, so nice close quarters. We can work at a 45 after that if you needed to. Okay, but again, same thing. Get the near foot in the ground, okay? Run the feet on contact, low to high. Close quarters, quick whistle. I want to see the guy accelerate through the man. We don't want to see him idle down. We don't want to see a pause. Through him, go through him fast. Okay, this is tracked near hip. So now we're in space. We're trying to take space away from the offensive man. We want to work downhill. We want to be in a good leverage position, right? I'm trying to get to this near hip. I want to be behind him. I don't want to be over the top, right? I got leverage from behind him. Maintain that leverage, right? We're just taking tight steps. Again, tagging off near foot, near shoulder at the end. Slow and controlled. All right, as you can see right there, as I hit pause, bad position. All right, I'm over the top. I can let that dude cut back. We don't want that. Stay in that back pocket. If he's going slow, that means I can get downhill fast. But really trying to break the drill down very elementary, very slow. All right, scooch technique, shuffle, whatever you want to call it. I'm in a good bend. I'm taking tight steps with my feet. I'm trying to keep my hips and my shoulders square. Just taking that space away. Very elementary, but working progressively through it. Now we come back. Now we're going to go a little faster. Okay, so all I do is I put a hat right there. You know, I've done this at youth camps, and I start the man at about 7 yards. Okay, we go at 10. Again, it doesn't matter the distance. The closer you get, it makes it a little bit easier on their end. We don't want it just to turn into like a race. Okay, so I put a hat right here. Not quite at the midpoint, but I told this receiver, run fast. As soon as you hit that hat, idle down. Okay, so now we're going to take that space away. We're going to get our butt downhill as fast as we can. Again, staying in the back pocket, not getting over the top. I can try to keep my shoulders square to the line of scrimmage, but my hips aren't. My hips got to turn and run, but my shoulders can stay square. All right, soon as that receiver starts to idle down, I have to idle down because I want to stay in the back pocket. All right, bang. Good finish there, near foot, near shoulder on the tag off. Again, fight to keep those shoulders square, especially when we start to break down. Right there, that's a pretty good rep with the feet. Watch the feet break. Bang, tight steps, under control. Good. And don't like that. Hips, try to get back square. Shoulders are definitely not square. All right, we got to get better at that rep, right? We want to stay square. Why do we want to stay square, right? If I'm square as a defender and that dude is running this direction and he puts his foot in the ground to go back, if I'm square, I can plant off my left foot and make a tackle without false step, all right? I'm efficient. Step with my left, press off of it, come back. So staying square allows you to go both directions efficiently. All right, get downhill, square up, near foot, near shoulder. Okay, so like to break that down. Progression, very simple. Okay, now we're going to do angle tackle. Okay, 45, get the near foot in the ground. I don't like how he stepped across himself. I would like it right down the middle. But I'm hit with my right shoulder. I want my nose on the near nipple. That's how we tackle. And now I want to run my feet through contact. Knock him back, right? That guy does a pretty good job because he ain't slowing down. He stays fast through contact. We like that. I club up. Okay, you can see the idle down there. You can see how that guy kind of slows down a little bit. Right? Try to stay fast. Stay fast. You might break your feet a little bit, but stay fast. All right, near foot, near shoulder. All right, take the extra step. Take the extra step. Get that right foot a little bit closer. Again, just nice close quarters, 5 yards apart. You know, you can see these offensive guys jumping a little bit. I don't love that. I want a little bit of a stop of the momentum. Man, there we go. Run through them. Don't jump. I don't like how those offensive guys are jumping. Stay fast. There we go. Okay, watch this. Watch his foot. Get the – see, near foot's back. We don't like that, right? Well, then take the extra step. Get the near foot close to him. Right? When we tackle, we want to knock guys back. What can allow us to knock guys back? Being strong and getting that near foot in the ground. Okay, now we just kind of put a different little wrinkle on it. Now we're just going down the line, all three. Again, nothing should change here. Still trying to get that near foot in the ground. Pretty good. Right, clubbing up, low to high, just like that first drill that we did, right? Clubbing up, low to high. You know, we always want, we would like to work at a 45-degree angle. Some people will club up like that. That ain't going to work. We need to work at a 45. We can work through them. We want to hit on the rise, but work through them. All right, just quick reps, get back. You know, what I would do differently this next time I did this, I would put a cone like right about there. I don't want these guys backpedaling so far. Slowing it down, right? Nice and quick, tight. Getting three reps, kind of a different angle. Hitting on that near foot, hitting on all those other things that we worked on. Bang, right? Get the near foot in the ground. All right, let's watch if he gets his right foot. Bang, not bad. Try to get it right down the crotch, more in between the legs. Last one, not bad. He's hugging though. Don't hug, club up. Activates your hips. Your hips are your power. Okay, I'm gonna keep moving. Okay, linebackers, couple different variations. Track the near hip. Okay, same drill. I've coached linebackers. I've coached running backs. I've coached DBs. Everything, hands, hips, feet for everything. Okay, just the tempo changes here. You can see him break, then speed up. A different variation of tracking your hip. Again, shoulders staying square, staying in that back pocket. Okay, phone booth, nice and close. Okay, clubbing up, feet, rolling the hips through. Low to high with the hands. All right, a lot of reps. Feet wide apart. We like the feet apart because that gives you a strong base. Now we're working on an angle. All right, I'm hit with my left shoulder. My left foot should be right down the crotch. Bang, right there. Good tackle. That's Graham Hevel. He's the D-line coach. He's a D-line coach at Mankato. Good feet. All right, suck the air out of the block. Bang, that's pretty good. By 39, Daniel Baguette from DeKalb, Illinois. Okay, working the other angle. Okay, watch Caleb Kaminsky here from Tomahawk. Watch how he kind of hops sideways and then goes at him. Would rather have him right downhill at a 45, more efficient. 39 does a good job there, right downhill at him. All right, same principles apply, though. There we go, good. Now we're just kind of taking space away, get downhill, break the feet. Again, they all kind of marries up with the track the near hip. It's really progression, essentially, okay? Block protection, now we're teaching them to play with their hands, okay? I want elbows tight, thumbs up. Right here, not here, not like that. Elbows tight, thumbs up, hit with the heel of the hand, low to high. Okay, I love this agile. I would coach any position you play. Any position you coach, I'd do this. All I'm working with these guys is being violent with their hands. Strike to lockout. Don't set it on the chest, be violent, right? That's soft. We want more. I want to snap through them. Go, let's see this rep. Bang, okay, got to get more power. Okay, let's see this rep. Don't fall step. Get your feet, stagger your feet if you need to. Watch how his hands are below his eyes, right? I want my hands at my eye level. I don't want them down here, right? His hips don't snap through, right? His hips never snap. See that? You got to get your hips through. That's where our power's at. Low to high with your strike of your hands is going to help with that. That's a freaking good rep right there. That's a wrestler. Kyle Koblinger, he's from Illinois, but great rep. You can see how he breaks, changes the spine angle. That's a term we use. There's the spine angle of that offensive man. We want to change it. Bang, look at that spine angle change. Beautiful, right? He's got hands inside, elbows tight, thumbs out. We want to dig out of that breastplate, hit the bullseye. Right in the back, that breastplate. That's what I call the bullseye. That's another part of this drill. Teach him to hit the bullseye, violent hands. Punch to lockout. No hesitation with it, not being soft. Okay, now I'm kind of working on the press out, the lockout part of it. And then you should finish on all of these. So I think the last ones here, we start steering with a rip or finishing with a rip, lockout, rip. Now we put the finish part of it, kind of broke it down to three pieces. So this, okay. All right, so this is near foot, near shoulder, force drill. Okay, now we're talking about setting an edge, cover two corner maybe, taking on a perimeter run block. Right, get the near foot in the ground, get my shoulders down so I can protect my leg. Bang, gotta stay square as I come off of it. Now again, I can play that way, I can play that way. Wherever the ball may go, I'm in a good position to go each way. All right, but get low, suck the air out of the block, near foot, near shoulder. Boom, put the foot in the ground, there it is. It's a great rep. Thomas Wojnarowski, great kid. I was going to say, it ain't Oak Creek. Man, I'm struggling. Sorry, Woj. Didn't know your high school. This is Jaden Hendrickson. He's from Peconica, Argyle. Okay, now we're going to put a block protection with a tackle. Going to put the two together. Okay, what do I do different on this drill next time? Don't backpedal. Have the guy just hot foot right here. Just have him hot foot right there. Have the guy come to him. The offensive man, you should see the momentum of that guy stop. All right, we're just putting those fundamentals in like a moving piece, changing it up. We go lockout, punch to lockout, punch to lockout, punch to lockout. There we go, don't dip the head, right? You watch this guy's hips. Julian McPhail, he's from Alaska. His hips don't get through. Come on, Juju, club up, get the hips through. Okay, there we go, punch to lockout, punch to lockout. Okay, now just shuffle, shuffle. Yes, Thomas Wojnarowski's from Oak Creek. Man, I don't know why I was hesitant on that.
Don't talk about Oak Creek on here, Coach.
Sorry.
It's a rival.
Oh, yeah, Franklin. My bad. So shuffle, shuffle, punch, okay? Keep the feet under the hips. Don't get the wide base. You can still step with the near foot. That's fine. Right there, step with the near foot. That's fine. Coach Hoagland. I know he's not coaching football anymore. He'd be mad at me.
He's at Homestead, I think, right?
I don't know. I hope so. He's still coaching. He's a heck of a coach. Shuffle, shuffle, punch, right? Just put him in a different position. Again, I want to punch the lockout. Punch the lockout. Get the guy away from me. Okay, linebackers. Okay, six-point stance. This is an O-line drill. I love it. All right, see who can fire. Who's scared? Who's hesitant? Again, elbows tight, thumbs out. Nothing changes there. Hit the bullseye. Hit the pec. Hit the breastplate. Hit the bullseye. Explode, explode, explode. Okay, now we got these 2x6s. They're a foot long. All right, just trying to give them a target, a smaller target. Hit the bullseye. Okay, you got to make sure you coach the guy holding it. He gives it a little bit because you don't want him to take it in the face. I know they got helmets on, but again, just hands. Connecting the hands and the hips here. Hands and the hips. Okay, now we do it on our feet. We give a set. Get them leaning. Whistle. Set. Whistle. All right, three reps. Okay, now we're, again, progressing, building, very elementary, and work to kind of the whole deal, putting the whole thing together. All right, now we're, the one thing I'd be careful with this, I don't like that big space between the feet. Probably could get them a little bit closer. I think one of these other reps is a little bit better. I go stay low, get those hands at the eye level. Feet a little too far apart. And so this could be taking on a receiver who's trying to block you, or it's a little bit more slow, or it's not, I don't want to use my shoulder. It's not as fast of a pace. But now I can play with my hands. Okay, why do we want to play with our hands? That allows us to play both sides of the man. And I'll get to that at some point. Here we go, near foot, near shoulder. Steer, 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 elbow tight, thumb out, pin it, accelerate the outside half. Right, just controlling that blocker. Okay, both feet. Right, nice and tight. Right, step with the left foot. Hand above the eye. Nothing changes. Okay, now I think we're going to go one way. There we go, two hands. Right, lock out the outside. Lock out the outside. Little wiggle on the inside. Little play. Okay, same thing going the other way. right? You got to bend. Stay low. Stay low. Keep a bend. Keep a bend. Keep a base. Keep the feet apart. Now we're going to steer one way, go the other. Fighting pressure. Trying to get your hips over the top. Again, just teach them to play with their hands. Okay, so this is why we want to, this is what we're trying to teach our guys right here. That could be a fullback blocking on outside zone. Could be a receiver blocking on a bubble. Could be probably not going to do it with an offensive lineman on a pull scheme, but maybe an offensive lineman on a zone scheme. When I take them down the middle, I can play this gap and I can play this gap. I can bonus. And guess what I do when I knock his butt back? I condense gaps. All right. Offensive guys want, they want expansion. They want space. We're going to eliminate that. And now just a little different variation. Lock them out, right? Punch to lockout. Extend. Find the ball, steer rip. All right, you can see me as the coach here. Okay. That's 8 o'clock there, coach. I'm going to put this up right here. There's more at the back end. Oop. We had 102 clips. There's no way we're going to get through that. But, hey, that's my email. This is me on Twitter. That's an O as in Olaf, Rendell, J-O-1-2. Email me, Twitter, whatever. I can get this sent to you guys. It's all yours. I want to thank you, coaches. I know we got coaches from all over the country here, but thank you, high school coaches, man.